Hello everyone, welcome back to CADmist. So in this video we are going to see how to use the design software CADpia V5. If you are not yet subscribed to our channel, please do click on the red button that is showing at the bottom right corner of the video. So without any delay, let us start the video. Under CADpia, we go for sheet metal design, that is generative sheet metal design. Enter your part name and give it as OK. And here you will be going for sketch. So I'll take a sketch on the base plane. I'll be drawing my sketch. So here I'll be drawing this rectangular feature with the help of centered rectangle. I'll be creating this feature. With the help of constraint, so let me give this distance, that is 100, and with the help of circle, considering this as my center, I'll be drawing a simple circle like this, then give a diameter, it is given as 100, that is R is 100 means diameter 200. Now go for constraints, make this and this as tangent. Then now I'll be specifying the length of this. It is given as 150. Specify it as 150. Give it as OK. So now you can see we have created our base profile. So go for quick trim and trim your extra curves. So like this, I have created my base profile. Then I'll exit from the sketch. Then go for wall. So before that you should define your sheet metal parameters. I'll be defining it as thickness as 3 and then bend radius as 6. Let us go for wall and add a wall feature for this. Like this we have added our base profile. Then let's go for sketch and make this cutout. Go for sketch, select the face. Here I'll be drawing this curve. Instead of drawing once again, you can go for offset also. Go for offset curve and select your curves. And the offset distance, it is given as 15. So instead of drawing this once again, we will be taking this as 15, that's all. Minus 15. So make this all as 15. Why? Because here you can see in the sketch, it is given as 15. So I have taken like this, then go for quick trim again and trim off your extra curves. And I'll exit from the sketch. Here you can see we have created our cutout feature. Then go for cutout. Under cutout you will be selecting your sketch, then give it as OK. Now you can see we have done a cutout. Then let's add these extra features. Here you can see a flange has been added to a distance of 20. So let us go for flange, select the edges, this edge, and here I'll be selecting the length. Here you can see the radius is 6 and the length it is given as 20. But if I give it as 20 over here, it will be taking 20 plus 6, 26 will be taken here. So here I'll be specifying it as 20 minus 6, that is 14. 14 is nothing but from this end it will be 20. This radius it will be taken as 6 and then this length it is taken as 14. So the total will be 20 mm. Then next, in order to add this end, go for flange again. Here also I'll be selecting my edge. Say this is my edge and the length I'll be giving it as 20 and the angle give it as 120. Why? Because here you can see. So here you can see the angle it is taken as 120 and the length we will be giving it as 14 itself. Then go for OK. Now you can see we have created our flange feature. And here you need to add one more feature. Go for flange again. Select the edge. This is my edge in reverse direction. The distance it should be. Here you can see the total distance it is taken as 180 and I have taken plus 20. So in order to make this full, So here the length I'll be giving it as 20 mm. Like this we'll be adding our flanges. Then here we can see there are two holes with the dia 6.5. So let us go for sketch, select your face. Here we'll be drawing a circle with the dia 6.5. And the distance from top edge it is given as 10. And the from left edge it is given as 15 mm. So with the help of mirror, let us mirror this curve. Go for mirror, select the center axis. So like this we'll be mirroring your curve. Exit from the sketch and again go for cutout, select your sketch, give it as OK. Now you can see we have made our cutouts. And here the edge fillet has been given, that is R5. For the go for corner, specify the radius as 5 and create your corners, say this edge and then this edge. Give it as OK. So now you can see we have created our flange feature. Then here you can see at the edges we have some more feature, that is a wall on edge feature. In order to create this, go for sketch, select your face. So I am taking sketches. Here you can see the distance has been specified, so that is why I am going for sketch. With the help of rectangular tool I will be drawing a rectangular feature. This must be a closed feature, so go for constraints and specify the distance. This it is given as 100, and here from this end it is not selectable. Why? Because it's a curved feature. So from here I will be giving it as 20, and also this ends I will be coinciding each other, and this height it is given as 20 mm. Exit from the sketch. Then now go for wall on edge. Under wall on edge go for sketch based. So type should be sketch based. Select your profile. This is your profile. And here you should select the edge where you want to place your wall feature. So I'll be selecting the bottom edge. So now you can see we have created our base. Go for preview. So here you should change the clearance mode. So instead of no clearance, we'll be giving it as bi-directional clearance. Like this, it will be coming, that is outside the feature. Give it as OK. So now you can see we have created our base feature. Here there is a small fillet, but the fillet is not mentioned here. So let me take it random. I'll be giving it as 8, and I'll select the edges. This edge and also this edge. Give it as OK. So now you can see we have created our sheet metal feature. So the same way you will be adding one more here. Go for sketch, select the face. Here you will be adding your sketch, that is I will be taking a rectangular feature. With the help of constraints, specify the distance, this is 100. And from here to here I will be giving it as 20. I will be constraining this coincide, and also we will be constraining this edge. Go for coincide. Exit from the sketch. The same way go for wall on edge. Select your sketch. This is your sketch, and also select the edge. So this is your edge. Give it as OK. So this is how you will be creating your sheet metal feature. So in the upcoming video let us see some more example. So this is all for now. Let's meet in our next video. Thank you.